Hey guys, welcome back. Today it's time for another recipe from me.
These are my whole wheat dinner rolls. Unlike my other soft dinner rolls, these actually have whole wheat flour as well inside. They're not 100% whole wheat, but you look at how airy and light and fluffy these are, and you're going to absolutely love this recipe. And it's very simple and very easy to make, so let's get started. I'm going to start by combining the dry ingredients. I've put my white flour, whole wheat flour and salt in a bowl. I'm going to give it all a good mix. You never want to put the salt directly in your yeast mixture. You want to put it in the flour so that it's not in direct contact with yeast. Next, I'm going to create my yeast mixture, and that is milk, yeast. I've got some honey, and I'm also going to add some melted butter. You can use sugar and you can also use oil instead. And I'll leave those substitutions on the blog. Now my butter is quite fairly yellow, so it's okay. It doesn't matter. Now I'm going to add the flour in three batches. Now you can do this in a stand mixer with a hook attachment, but based on my masterclass, many of you have asked me to show you how to do the dough by hand. So I have promised that some of the dough recipes I'm going to do by hand and some by stand mixer. So this one is going to be by hand. And I've also promised you to show some with baker's yeast, because many of you get fresh and not the powdered kind. So today we use the powdered, but in some of my recipes I do have fresh baker's yeast used as well. They work quite similar, and I'll leave all the extra notes in the blog. Now you see I put almost all my flour. This is the end of it. Now I'm going to take this out on a work surface and I'm going to knead it. You want to knead it for about 7 to 10 minutes. Yes, kneading by hand is takes a little longer, but if you do it right, you want to use the heel of your hand and knead it well. Okay, if you can always switch hands and do it. Now you want to make sure that you knead it until it's soft, elastic, and avoid the temptation to add too much of flour. The moment you add too much of flour, you get very dense dough. So you want to continue to knead it until it's about 5 to 10 minutes. It's smooth, soft and elastic. It'll still be slightly tacky, and that's okay. Now this, you see that when you press the dough, it should spring back. Now I'm going to put this in my oiled bowl. And I'm going to cover it and let it rest for about 60 to 90 minutes until it almost doubles in size. Once it's doubled in size like this, I'm going to take it off on a lightly flat surface, and I'm going to remove all the air first. There you go. Next, I'm going to divide this into 12. I'm making 12, which are fairly big in size, but you can also make 16 out of these. You can use a weighing scale to measure them. They're about 65 to 70 grams. And again, it all depends on the size you want. These are not fairly small. A kind of average size would be about 60 grams. Now I'm going to create a roll. And the best way to do that is to first pinch all the seams at the bottom, and then on a non-flat surface, kind of roll it in the palm of your hand like this. Can you see what I'm doing? It's a very simple and easy way to do it. But if you use too much of flour on the working surface, you will not be able to roll it. And you don't want to overdo it, because then you will tear the little kind of firm film that you have created on top. So don't do it too much, just until you've got a nice tension. There you go. Now I've got all these done. I'm going to put them in my 9 inch baking square baking pan. This is an 8 inch, but a 9 inch would also work. Now I'm going to cover these and let them rest for about 45 minutes to 60 minutes until they're almost double in size like this, and then I'm going to brush them with egg wash and put them in the oven. My oven is already preheating, and I'm going to bake these for about 20 to 25 minutes until they're nice and golden. I'm going to brush these with butter. The butter flavor adds nice. And I'm going to cover these with a clean kitchen cloth for a few minutes so that they stay nice and soft. Now these are all ready to be used, and these freeze well, and I'll leave all the instructions for that on my blog. Look at how light and fluffy they are. They're absolutely delicious, and the recipe for this is on my blog. Don't forget to get it, the link below.
Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and of course subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos from me. I'll see you in another video soon. And of course, if you do try my recipe, don't forget to tag me on any social media. Veena Asmanov. Bye-bye.